Family members should be entering their vehicles. We'll start moving vehicles into the lineup. Thank you. Mr. Albright, family, friends, online viewers, and most importantly, graduates of 2020, I would like to thank you and welcome you to tonight's unique yet very special occasion. Graduates, we certainly know this was not the way you wanted your senior year to end. Instead of a prom, senior pranks, and proper goodbyes, you were introduced to e-learning. And if you listen real carefully, you can hear people booing from their living rooms right now. No, this is not the way it was supposed to play out. Well, you just got your welcome to the real world a little sooner than others. Life rarely plays out exactly how you think that it should, and that's okay. I've watched you come up from elementary through middle school, and now having completed high school, you're ready to take on this thing called the real world. You've got this. Congratulations. To begin tonight's ceremony, we have a pre-recorded speeches from our salutatorian Juliana Kuzniar and our valedictorian Catherine Walters. Enjoy.
Dr. Christ, Mr. Albright, Mr. Foltz, faculty, staff, board members, family, friends, and last but certainly not least, graduates of 2020. We finally reached the finish line, the moment that all high schoolers yearn for as they're cramming for tests, completing assignments, or being woken up by their alarm at 6:30 in the morning. We've done it. The hard work and determination that we have carried with us throughout the last 4 years has allowed us to tackle only one of the many milestones we will face in life. It's hard to sit down and write a speech reflecting on our years in high school when it feels a little incomplete, when it feels as though there was so much more that we had to do together before our journey came to a close. It's easy to dwell on the missing piece of our year, but after much thought, I began to realize that there are endless things to celebrate as we look back on our time at River Ridge. I believe one of those things is the relationships that we have all been able to form together and the things we have been able to learn from one another. Some of us have been going to River Ridge since preschool, while others have only been a part of our community since junior year of high school. The thing is, it doesn't matter how long you have been attending this school. We are all an important part of our little family here at River Ridge. Our class of 2020 has not always gotten along or seen eye to eye on every issue, but what is family without a little bickering? Even though it took us a while to make decisions together, we did eventually land on a design for our senior shirts, so I would call that a win. Through these disagreements, we have been able to grow as a class and learn more about ourselves as people. During my time here, I have learned what it means to be a friend. I have realized that friendship is support and kindness, but also so much more than that. Over the years, we have continued to grow closer and closer as a class and continuously show our selflessness and care for one another. If at any point one of us was having a bad day at school, I can guarantee that someone would realize it and try to make us feel better. For the last few months of our senior year, we haven't stopped lifting one another up. It's been hard to accept the way that the year is ending, but it's easier to do when you're in a class as good as this one and you have memories as good as ours. Our relationships with one another have not faltered throughout this experience, and I know that they won't fade after we graduate either. I'd like us to take a moment to look at the people around us. Take a moment to look at the school. Remember that all of these people around us and the halls of this building that we have walked through for years have molded us into the people that we are today. Remember the teachers, parents, and classmates that have assisted us to get where we are now. Hold on to those relationships and experiences that we have had throughout our time in high school. Be thankful for them. And remember that there is so much more out in the world for us to discover. Be thankful for that. Congratulations, class of 2020. We've done this together. Here's to all of our memories and bright futures.
Dr. Christ, Mr. Albright, Mr. Foltz, graduates, board members, faculty, staff, and friends. I am pleased to be standing before you all today, virtually, after the most successful senior skip day ever. All jokes aside, I think we can all agree that this is not how we expected the school year to go. There is no doubt that this class of 2020 has lost out on many memories that would have come with our last few months of high school. While we may feel like these memories have been stolen from us, I think it is important to remember that this isn't the end. Senior year may represent the end of our career here at River Ridge, but also the beginning of everything else. If there is one thing I have learned from these past few months, it is to appreciate things before it is too late. When I walked into school on March 16th, I didn't know it was going to be my last day. And if I did, I might have done things a little differently. I would have taken the time to thank the teachers who have helped me so much during my high school career. I would have made sure that our class got a picture together on our last day of high school. And maybe I even would have taken my time leaving at the end of the day instead of sprinting out to beat the buses. I hope that we can learn from our experiences the past few months and come out the other side with a carpe diem mentality. While writing this speech, I spent hours looking for a quote that would capture the spirit of our experience. Eventually, I landed upon this one. Enjoy the little things in life, for one day you may look back and realize they were the big things. While we may not have gotten the traditional graduation, prom, or class trip, we did get to experience the everyday life with our friends, classmates, and teachers. Those everyday, unextraordinary experiences have shaped us more than any trip to New York would have. Don't get me wrong, New York seems pretty cool, but if given a choice between a Broadway show and Mr. Van de Gogh acting out Romeo and Juliet, I would choose the latter every time. And besides, we all know Raiden would have clapped the entire way home from New York. It is a shame that we are starting a new chapter of our lives with so much uncertainty surrounding us. Between the ongoing pandemic, riots, and everything else, there's no telling what our future could look like. However, where there is uncertainty, there is also opportunity. Opportunity to seize the day. While our time at River Ridge may have been cut short, it has provided us with the drive we need to achieve whatever we may put our minds to. Whether our futures include attending college, serving in the armed forces, or joining the workforce, I am confident that every one of us will find success, and more importantly, happiness. We're moving on to bigger and better things, but even as we leave many things
Mr. Albright, River Ridge School Board members, it is with great pleasure that I inform you the class of 2020 has met all requirements for graduation. We will now present the diplomas to our graduates. James C. Allen, grandson of Denise Anderson. James plans to go to school for acting and to hopefully become an actor. James, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Come on up. Yep. Thank you. Yep. Down that way.
Oh, that way.
Yep. You're good. Raymond Levi Allen, son of Rocky and Margie Allen. Ray plans to join the U.S. Navy. Ray, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Sean J. Anderson, son of Carl Anderson. Sean plans to attend Highland Community College with an undecided major. Sean, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Brianna Marie Veronica Boop, daughter of Nicolene Boop and Brian Boop. Brianna is attending Highland Community College for general education classes, then transferring to a four-year university to major in environmental science. Brianna, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Kaylin Janice Cowell, daughter of Laura and William Cowell. Kaylin is developing skills in the arts and pursuing a homestead lifestyle. CJ, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Natalie Paige Eddy, daughter of Cap and Cecilia Eddy. Natalie plans to attend Highland Community College with an undecided major. Natalie, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Andrew Shane Green, son of Christina Hammer. Andrew is entering the workforce. Andrew, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Lydia Denise Grossinger, daughter of Sam and Terry Grossinger. Lydia is attending Roosevelt University to major in business. Lydia, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Madeline Murphy Clippert, daughter of Monica and Mark Clippert. Madeline plans to attend the University of Iowa in the fall to pursue a career in the nursing, specializing in juvenile diabetes. Madeline, advance your tassel. It's up there. Congratulations. Juliana M. Kuzniar, daughter of Michael and Laura Kuzniar. Juliana is attending Iowa State University to major in kinesiology with an emphasis on pre-health professions. Juliana, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Thank you. Brandon Nicholas Lamping, son of Teresa and Bill Lamping. Brandon is entering the workforce. Brandon, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Dylan Robin Landwehr, son of Jody and Melody Landwehr. Dylan is attending Highland Community College for civil engineering, then transferring to the University of Wisconsin-Platteville to finish his degree. Dylan, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Thank you. Derek William Lehman, son of Bill and Tina Lehman. Derek is attending the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign to major in public policy and law. Derek, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Arthur D. Leitz, son of Christina and Gary Leitz. Arthur will attend Columbia Chicago College, major in graphic design and study the arts. Arthur, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Andrew J. Merkel, son of Bill and Melissa Merkel. Andrew is attending the University of Wisconsin-Madison to pursue a degree in business. Andrew, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Sarah Catherine Miller, daughter of Kevin and Sue Miller. Sarah is attending Highland Community College to study biology and art. Sarah, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Zachary William Nolan, son of Sharon Randall and Bob Nolan. Zach is entering the workforce. Zach, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Taden Michael Patterson, son of Terry and Lori Patterson. Taden is attending Clark University to study pre-physical therapy. Taden, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Abby Jean Richmond, daughter of Ted and Sarah Richmond. Abby is attending the University of Dubuque and majoring in human health services with a focus on occupational therapy. Abby, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Yep, you're good. Thank you. Jekka J. Sample, daughter of Seth Sample. Jekka is attending Illinois State University, majoring in psychology. Jekka, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Destiny Rose Schwartz, daughter of Alanda Holtz and Luke Schwartz. Destiny is attending a four-year college to participate in track and major in elementary education and minoring in psychology. Destiny, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Keegan Alexander Steins, son of Sean Steins. Keegan is entering the workforce. Congratulations, Keegan. Thank you. Madison Marie Stolk, daughter of Jody Coons and Scott Stolk. Madison is attending Iowa State University to major in biology. Madison, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Raiden K. Taifa, son of Laura Horke and Joshua Taifa Sr. Raiden is attending the University of Wisconsin-Platteville to major in marine biology. Raiden, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Thank you. Joseph William Tippett, son of Ron and Judy Tippett. Joe is attending the University of Wisconsin-Platteville to major in civil engineering. Joe, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Dalton Anthony Wachter, son of Mark and Jean Wachter. Dalton is attending Highland Community College for general education classes, then transferring to the University of Wisconsin-Stevens Point, majoring in forestry management. Dalton, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Catherine Mary Walters, daughter of Corey and Laura Walters. Kate is attending St. Ambrose University to major in biology on the pre-dental track. Kate, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Riley William Carl Walter, son of Raymond and Christy Walter. Riley is attending the University of Dubuque to major in nursing. Riley, advance your tassel. Congratulations. Andrew James Wooster, son of Stephanie Wooster and Brian Wooster. Andrew is attending Ellsworth Community College for the liberal arts and then will transfer to a four-year college for computer science. Andrew, advance your tassel. Congratulations. In absentia tonight, Joe Diaz and Patrick Cahill. Ladies and gentlemen, the River Ridge graduated class of 2020. Honk those horns, people, honk those horns.